If the mayor could, he'd say, someone get the Jewish kid a stool. Tripe. I don't remember how exactly I became Mayor Menino's chief of staff. I recall vaguely that we were in his living room, Sal Lamatina was there, and there was tripe. I remember much more clearly the moment I first met Mayor Menino, more than a decade ago. Typically, more than half the city typically, I bumped into him on the street. It was a beautiful day, warmer than this and clear. And a friend who was with me said to the mayor, it's great weather we're having. And Mayor Menino looked to the sunny sky and said, that I'm not in charge of. I didn't believe him then. I wouldn't believe him today. The mayor, who never sought higher office, has one now. And I can envision him there. I can see him in my mind. And it's just like when he was in the front seat of his truck, as we would slow at a stoplight next to a pack of school kids strolling home. And he would roll down his window. He would lean his elbow on the door frame. He'd put his hand out the window just a bit and give him a little finger wave. And the looks on the kids' faces, they were equal parts shock and adoration. And that's how I imagine him now, a little finger wave as he comes up on his mother and father, on Senator Kennedy, on John Keneally and Junior Lombardi, on Justine Liff and Edna Bino, on Mark Sweeney, on Stephen Odom, on little Martin Richard. On their faces is the shock that's been on ours all week. Mayor Menino is not supposed to be here yet. And on their faces, adoration. He wasn't supposed to be here yet. He was supposed to have more time. Not more time to relax, but more time to be in the mix of things. He always wanted to be in the mix of things. He was anguished not to be there on Boylston Street in the moments after the blasts. And he said to me over the phone, you are my eyes and my ears. I am your eyes. And I saw thousands today lining the neighborhoods you transformed with signs in every language, ready to repay a debt to Angela that we never can, since she gave us you. I am your ears. And I hear in Tommy and Susan and in your six grandkids and their savvy and their smarts and their sweetness and their spitfire, beautiful echoes of you. You will be proud of them as ever. I am your eyes, and I can still see you in my dining room, pestering Hannah just two for ice cream. I can still see her shaking her head no. It's a good thing she didn't need building permits. I can see you marvel at our little one, Noah, and how much you enjoyed that his initials spelled new. You always said that the status quo was moving backward. I am your ears, and I hear in my own broken voice, and in Michael's and Dot's, and Peggy's and Martha's, and in your staff from 1993 until now, I loved him. Team Menino loved you. They loved you when you got them into doctor's appointments and into schools. They loved you when you told them to get degrees, and if they replied that they had one, when you told them to get another one, They loved you because you shoved them into their futures. They loved you during magic hour, on a Friday at dusk, when you'd sit at your table and regale with stories of the early campaigns and the early days and the way things used to be and the way they could. They loved you when you said things like, I am mayor of all the people, and government is for helping people, and when you meant it, and when that made it okay for them to believe it was true and to make it so. They loved you when they staffed your phone banks. They loved you when they hung signs for you. They loved you when they unhung some other signs. And you loved them back. They loved you when they counted your homeless and delivered your toys. Team Menino loved you when they called again and again over the last 4 days to say, what can I do to help? And they love that they learned that from you. They loved you when they filled your offices this weekend and stayed past midnight and broke all sorts of rules to pull all this off, and they loved that they learned that from you too. They loved you as they stood watch overnight in Faneuil Hall, silenced in the wake of a million grateful footsteps. A machine, the outsiders called it, but how could it be? It had your big beating heart. I am your eyes, and I see you departing now. But I am your ears, and I can still hear you calling across your office when someone great was leaving, but not yet gone. And with one half mischief and one half pride, you would not too subtly whisper, what would we have done without him? He's a good kid. He was. And this city loved him, and so did I.